Greenheck. Building value in air.
Hi, and welcome to a technical overview of Greenheck's HVLS fans. Today I'm going to be looking at our DC drive. On our low voltage side of the drive, we have a 24 volt output, a ground output, fire plus, fire minus, data plus, and data minus. This 24 volt output will not be needed in all applications. You'll have to check to see what sort of control you're using. We have a dip switch, which sets up the communication biasing. This will either be set to down, up, up for the first fan in the series, or down, down, down for all additional fans. To set this for the first fan in the series, again, down, up, up. Below that, we have an addressing bank of dip switches. This needs to be independent for every fan that is connected within a network. Typically, the first fan in the network is set for address number 2. Here we have our high voltage input. This can take single phase 110 or 220 power. We've got our ground, one leg of voltage, and the other. It does not matter if this is neutral and this is L1, or if this is L1 and this is neutral. Similarly with 240, the inputs do not matter. Down here we have our motor connections. This is the high voltage output to the motor. The Hall effect sensor, which gives feedback to the drive. If this is plugged in incorrectly, upside down, or not all the way, the motor will stall and think that there's an impact detection because it can't tell the direction that it's rotating. Finally, we have our ground connection. Without the ground connection, the motor will also behave erratically. There's also a cheat sheet inside the drive cover. If you ever have any other questions, please reach out to our customer support group.